Hello and welcome. My name is Shailesh Kumar and you're watching National Defense. Look, today I am sitting in the cockpit of 4.5 generation aircraft Spot, which HAL, the pride of India, is building for the training of Indian Air Force pilots. And this aircraft will also be used in the combat role.
So I'm Group Captain Thakur. I'm the Deputy Chief Test Pilot at HAL Flight Operations. And I was in Air Force for 24 years, and for the last 3 years I've been test flying for HAL. This is the latest prototype that HAL has made, and perhaps the only one of its kind, which is the Supersonic Omni-role Fighter Trainer. So as the name suggests, and the acronym for this is SPOT. We picked up the Sport from Supersonic Omni-role Trainer name. This is based on an LCA airframe, an LCA engine. It's got everything that a pilot wishes for, the entire wish list of all pilots that have ever communicated with us, and in my experience and the experience of the entire team, has been incorporated in this aircraft. It has been a very rapid turnaround from LCA Mach 1 to this kind of a standard. So we've incorporated a large area display, a side stick controller. We've got two cockpits. The trainer certification will get faster with this, and this is 4.5 generations plus. The weapon payload remains the same as LCA. The fuel payload remains the same as LCA. However, we give it newer weapons. We give it newer avionics, sensors, and the works. We've taken it to the different, absolutely new level, and I'm sure every pilot that comes across this kind of a machine will be surprised, enthusiastic, and will be very excited to fly this kind of an aircraft. Now, why it is required? Air Force has got an excellent training, so they've got a basic stage, intermediate stage, and an advanced stage, and thereafter the fighter pilot becomes an actual fighter pilot in the squadron. Unfortunately, after completing advanced jet training, the skill levels of an Air Force pilot is quite high, but his exposure to the newest systems is a little limited. That he gets only once he goes to a fighter squadron. Whereas on a platform like the Sport, he will get exposure to helmet mounted display, cruise missiles, beyond visual range missiles. He'll get exposure to an active AESA radar, IRST, in-flight refueling, night strikes. The kind of things that you will only get exposed to very late in your life, we will do it early in a fighter pilot's life. We will expose him using the trainers that we have, and in a very short span of about 6 months, we'll give him a number of sorties, expose him to the entire bandwidth of all equipment, weapons and sensors that the Indian Air Force has, and similarly we will do for the Navy as well. Now, if you walk towards the cockpit, you will be able to make out what we have in the cockpit, and we can take a look around in the cockpit. So the first thing that is to be understood about this aircraft, that while it's a trainer, majorly it is a fully combat proven and effective platform. If you see in the configuration that we have, this has got the entire suite of what the LCA flies and what the Su-30 flies and what the Mirage flies, and all the high performance aircraft in the Air Force presently and the new ones getting inducted is looked after by the configurations on this aircraft. This is an actual operational configuration. We got the radar page, we got a map display, we got 3D display, and as we fly the aircraft around, we will see that it's got very high performance, and we got the EW system. It's an aircraft which is complete in itself. It does training for fighter pilots. It does basic level of training, advanced training, and lead-in fighter training. And over and above that, it does all combat roles as effectively as any fighter aircraft that the Air Force might have. Now, what we put here is a large area display, and you see all the variations in the displays. We've got a 3D display on the right side and a digital map generator towards the left side. We've got the radar display, and we've got interleaved modes on the radar which will come up here. So we've got two modes here, the radar in air-to-air mode and the radar in air-to-surface mode. So all of these features are absolutely brand new. Most of the Air Force pilots have not seen it. Once they see it, they would appreciate what kind of work has gone into this, and we should be hitting our certification as quickly as we can. We are modifying one of the prototypes that we have, and I think within a span of about 1 year, we should be good to go for productionizing this kind of an aircraft. All right, the major shift that we've done to the control system is that right in the center, I will have a large MFD. I've removed the control stick from here and I put it on the side just like it is on the Western aircraft, and it's got a side stick, which even the Rafale has. Some of the American variants, the F-35, F-22, and even the F-16 in the older variants have. So there is a side stick controller which will be new for the Air Force pilots, but will give you exceptional training for a high performance aircraft like a Rafale, for which this kind of a trainer is intended. Now I'm going to just expose you to what are the combat capabilities of this kind of a platform. Now LCA Tejas can carry as much load as a 3.5 to 4 generation aircraft can, but a little lesser than Su-30 or even the Rafale. So that does not limit the aircraft in any way. We carry 2 to 3 very high precision laser guided bombs. We can carry cruise missiles, which we are developing simultaneously. On this aircraft, we are planning an unmanned team controller where the pilot sitting in the back need not be a trainee, need not be an instructor. He can be a weapon systems operator who will control an unmanned combat aerial vehicle who will be flying on the wing of this kind of an aircraft. So the unmanned aircraft will go inside the enemy territory, whereas this aircraft will wait at the border or just inside and clear the skies for the unmanned aircraft. We will have a team like that of 4 to 6 LCAs and about 15 to 20 unmanned aircraft who will go deep inside the enemy territory and will be able to strike them. And that is the philosophy that the world is turning towards, and we are doing that on this aircraft. In the rear cockpit, you will have a full-fledged controller for the control of the unmanned aircraft. As far as the cruise missiles is concerned, we are also developing cruise missiles for this aircraft, and we are developing swarm drones. It's a big thing which is happening in the industry now. So we are going to have a large canister, about 3 of them on the LCA, which will carry 8 drones each. The canisters will be fired. They'll travel a distance about 50 to 70 kilometers. The drones will come out of the canister, and thereafter the drones will fly for another 1 hour, about a distance of 150 kilometers, giving you a total lethal range of about 200 to 220 kilometers, where the drones will go search for their target, go vertical and impact the target. We'll have a warhead of its own right in the center of the body of the drone, will be a warhead. So I will have on this kind of an aircraft about 24 of such drones who will go as a team, who will communicate with each other, find each other's targets, find their own respective targets, look for the targets once they are over it, and dive towards the target with their own warhead. They will impact on the target and cause the destruction that is intended.
Sport is basically a trainer version that we are planning to do, and if you look at it, it is a version which is much beyond what anybody has seen it in this exhibition. You have seen the cockpit layout. It's a fully glass cockpit what we have made, wide this one display is there, and it is meant to simulate various fighter aircrafts, including Su-30, Mirage, or Jaguar. Anything that you want, you can convert, you can get the pilot trained on that aircraft with this trainer.
And it has combat capability also?
It's basically a trainer. It's basically a trainer, and it can give you a training even on the weapons.
Okay. So it would be a 4 plus?
It is not a generation wise. It's a basically a new concept of having one supersonic trainer, which is never there. All the trainers are subsonic. So it's a supersonic trainer in which we can simulate many number type of aircrafts. The cockpit configuration is simulated, and it can also simulate weapon delivery.
Thank you so much.